In 1967, the Nobel Committee awarded me the Nobel Prize. So my wife and I traveled to Stockholm, and so did our two children, then grown up. It was a beautiful feast, and for the purpose I had to give a lecture on the main subject of the prize, namely the theory of the energy in stars. Fortunately, I had available the work by Icko Iben on stars of mass about 3 times the mass of the Sun, going to the end of the supply of hydrogen, then the center contracting and the outside expanding into a red giant. So in this Nobel lecture, I reported essentially this further work in the evolution of stars. The evolution of stars has become a subject of great interest to astrophysicists generally, and you go through all the stages, formation of a red giant, and then in the center of it you make Salpeter's process, making carbon-12, and then it contracts some more. Temperature gets higher, it gets to 1 billion degrees, and then 2 carbon nuclei can react and make neon and magnesium, and then finally 2 oxygen nuclei can interact and make silicon, and finally silicon will capture the helium nuclei, which are now present in abundance because it is now sufficiently hot to release helium nuclei from other ambient nuclei, and silicon then captures one by one alpha particles, helium nuclei, finally ending up in nickel 56, which is the biggest nucleus, which is completely composed of alpha particles. So that is then the end of the story. The nickel 56, after a few weeks, transforms into iron 56, which happens to be a particularly abundant isotope and element in all the world. And this is what I have just given you, is an explanation how this comes about and how elements are actually formed, not by the alpha, beta, gamma process.